Good afternoon. Thank you for this opportunity, for giving me the opportunity to present my paper on exploring the multidimensional scale of attitude towards lesbians and gay men. Can we move to the next slide? When it comes to LGBT reformations in terms of law in India, the reformation has been quite slow. In particular, homosexuality was a crime until 2018, 6 September, when Section 377 of IPC was removed. However, this legal reformation did not show as much social reformation as expected, for which we need to practice inclusion in workplace more aggressively, have sensitization programs, screening techniques, especially in fields like medical, legal, and police workplaces, so that when a homosexual individual approaches with a criminal already crying as a victim, they are not subjected to a secondary crime. And in order to develop such programs, we need a standard tool. This study is a step forward for the same. Can we move to the next slide? Next slide, please. The multidimensional scale of attitude towards lesbians and gay men, which was developed by George Ghetto and Mary Fontaine and Nuno Santos Carneiro, was used in this study. This was developed originally for Portuguese population. In the current study, we used 357 police personnel with their consent from Ahmedabad City Police. Next slide, please. The study had two parts. The first was the principal component analysis, and the second was the principal access factoring. Next slide. Next slide, please. The first part of the study, which is the principal component analysis, is basically an attempt to replicate the original study that was done by Ghetto and the other authors. So there were originally 33 items in the scale, of which 27 was retained by the authors. We used this 27 items for the PCA with a oblique rotation, oblimin, to achieve a simple structure. And since in the original scale there were 4 components, we fixed the number of components to be extracted as 4. And the sample that we used were found adequate for this analysis. Next slide, please. The result we got, we could not replicate the same structure in current population as in the original scale. Amongst the key differences was the total variance in the original scale explained was 56.7%, and in the current study it was 38.9%. The 4 components loaded on different items and different number of items as well, giving a completely different structure. And the items eliminated on grounds of commonality or zero loadings were also different in those 2 studies. Next slide, please. So in the part 2 of the study, we decided to do an independent exploratory factor analysis with all the 33 items, and again using oblimin rotation. And we used parallel analysis method to decide the number of factors to be retained. Next slide, please. 6 factors were extracted, which explained 34.06% of the total variance. Items number 4, 8, 9, 28, and 30 had to be removed. Now, item number 4, 8, 9, and 30 were such items which describe parenting and child-rearing practices by homosexual couples, which is still a very hypothetical situation in India. Whilst item number 28 was an item which described inclusion of a homosexual individual in workplace, the zero loading in this item shows that probably in Ahmedabad police, homosexuals are underrepresented. Next slide, please. The 6 factors extracted were named according to the kind of items they loaded on and the correlation between the factors themselves. The first factor was named acceptance towards homosexuality. Second was intolerance towards homosexuality. Third, rejection of proximity. 4th, opposing using homosexuality as an identity. 5th, legal and civil support. And 6th, perception of homosexuality, homosexual partners. Next slide, please. In conclusion, I would like to say in the first part of the study, though the original scale structure could not be replicated, we get some very informative insights. For example, the reason why it cannot, the same structure does not apply in India is probably because India and Portugal have very different timeline when it comes to LGBT reformation. While Portugal accepted homosexuality back in 1982, in India, any section of LGBT was accepted in 1994 when the eunuch community was only recognized. Amongst other factors are, India is a large country with the second largest population and six major religion, 28 different states with different cultures. Whereas in comparison to that, Portugal is a smaller country, less population, homogeneous culture. Catholic is the main religion. So the struggle for acceptance in India becomes double. Plus, poverty level, most of the population is under poverty level. In such situation, it becomes a burden for the government to accept a minority community. However, the second part of the study, the structure obtained seems promising, provided it is subjected to a confirmatory factor analysis and a validation study. Thank you.